need a plan to get it. What's up?
Graduates in the medical speech language and pathology program, as well as those in the doctorate in occupational therapy, our inaugural class. On behalf of the faculty from the graduate program in medical speech pathology, including Dr. Julia Gosto. Andrew Chrysler, Dr. Jargon, who could not make it today, but we acknowledge him. Professor Kathleen Fitzgerald, Professor Bonnie Lipton, Professor Leoff, Dylan Mando. Michaela Medved. Dr. Benjamin Kowalski. Professor Brittany Palmer. Dr. Laura Sylvia. Professor Julia Chernova. Professor Rita Rosenmith. Dr. Marissa Barrera. I am your Dean of Health Sciences and your Medical SLP Program Director. And we collectively congratulate you for achieving outstanding, and we collectively congratulate you for achieving outstanding success and arriving at the milestone as you embark today on your clinical careers. So I share this privilege today with my esteemed colleague, Dr. Mindy Garfinkel, Interim Program Director for the Doctorate in Occupational Therapy. On behalf of the faculty from the Occupational Therapy Doctorate Program, Dr. Mia Wong and Levy, Dr. Alexander Wagner, who can't be here today, Dr. Cesare Bodhi, Professor Melanie Evangelista, and me, Dr. Mindy Garfinkel. Congratulate you on our inaugural classes of occupational therapy doctors, on the tremendous accomplishment and successes that you experienced on the road to becoming scholar practitioners. Please allow me to welcome to the podium the Dean of the Katz School of Science and Health, Dr. Paul Russo.
This is just a recognition. I'm so touched by the work that you do. You see patients all day long. How many hours do you spend in clinic?
400.
Minimally 400 and then more. Right? But you're in class, you spend all the rest of the day with patients. But then, you know, when I think of Jillian's project, you know, she dug into a lot of data and made really informed commentary on policy. And that kind of work changes systems. And I think of Miriam, besides going to class all day and seeing patients all day, she wrote a protocol for parents, she wrote a protocol for parents to be able to navigate government standards and government expectations in order to meet goals and get their needs. And I think of the OT, the SLP department, when you're doing 3,500 sessions in telehealth. Well, since when did we do that, right? But what you wrote with the diagnostics and the protocols to deal with it, this is so far beyond simply seeing patients. This is a testament to your commitment, to your scholarship and your skills. And I think this is what sets you apart and why we are so proud to have you. And I thank you again. And I think as scholar practitioners, you really deserve to give yourselves a hand. And families, you have to understand how important this is. These are not just people who are going to work in a practice, but these are people who will be shaping the field and shaping practice. So congratulations.
Please allow me the privilege to introduce Clinical Assistant Professor and Clinical Supervisor, Professor Brittany Palmer. Professor Palmer has been an integral member of the Katz School of Science and Health for the last 5+ years. She is starting a new clinical adventure this summer at a large New York City hospital and research institution. So today, on behalf of the faculty and students, we would like to recognize Professor Palmer this afternoon for her undying commitment, compassion, and enthusiasm that is palpable both in and out of the classroom. Please welcome Professor Palmer. Thank you so much, Dr. Barrera. And I hope to get through this. So, good afternoon. My name is Brittany Palmer, and it is my honor to welcome all of you here today to the 2023 White Coat Ceremony for the graduate programs in Speech Language Pathology and Occupational Therapy. At YU, I've had the privilege of helping guide future clinicians along their clinical journeys in speech-language pathology, and I've done it alongside a stellar faculty, comprised of individuals who truly personify competence, compassion, and commitment. I couldn't be prouder of our programs, our faculty, or our students. The past several years have indeed been a journey for us all. On the administrative side, our programs have been growing and expanding in exponential ways. And thanks to the leadership of Dean Russo and our phenomenal program directors, we are thriving as leaders in the professional health services educational community. And we couldn't be here today without the outstanding efforts of our faculty members. I personally have learned so much from them over the years, and I truly believe that I'm a better educator and a clinician because of their insight and support. They have put in countless hours counseling students, grading papers, and finding creative ways to teach across all levels of student experience. And that's no easy task. And I've witnessed firsthand that light bulb that goes on when a student gets it because faculty members go that extra step. It's rewarding on so many levels, both for the students and the faculty. So let's give it up for your faculty members. Now, graduates, I'm looking at you. You are all here today because you chose a path where you have the opportunity to make a tangible difference in thousands of people's lives. You have chosen to be healthcare professionals. And what does that mean? Well, I've been proud to serve on the clinical team in the speech language pathology department and serve as a clinical supervisor for several years. And what I've always imparted to my students, and I think half of you probably won't remember this, is that we as clinicians are three things. We're scientists, we're teachers, and we're counselors. One of the most beautiful things to see as a clinical supervisor is when your students make breakthroughs or have learning moments in each of these areas. For instance, when a student understands the purpose of writing a rationale, which is essentially a scientific explanation for why you're doing what you're doing in therapy, right? You know. That's a learning moment or a breakthrough, right? When for the first time, a student explicitly explains how to physically complete a task to a patient who might not have that much kinesthetic awareness, right? That's a learning moment. When a patient divulges sensitive personal information and the student has to respond with words that are both professional and empathetic, that's a learning moment. And it's in this collection of these little learning moments that the magic happens. As these moments accumulate, we as a faculty are able to watch the transition from student status to health professional. And as an educator like myself, making sure students learn from these learning moments is one of the most important things I do. There's no doubt that every student here has had their own series of learning moments. But of course, it hasn't been an easy journey. It's had ups and its downs. I'm sure you all had some late nights with some empty Red Bull cans on your desk that you had to clean up the next day, right? You might have had tears along the way, tears of frustration, maybe tears of loss, or maybe tears that, you know, things were just a little bit too overwhelming. But guess what? You made it. You are here today. You woke up every day and you fought to be here in this moment. And it's that perseverance that will get you through anything. Because remember, too, you had moments of excellence, moments of success, and unhinged curiosity. You pushed yourself to be uncomfortable because you knew that would make you a better clinician. And I assure you that it did. You went through it all because at the end of the day, you want to make this world a better place. And now you can. My advice going forward for all of you is this. Never stop learning from your learning moments. Never stop being curious and follow through on that curiosity. Your patients will benefit and so will you. We are so proud of each and every one of you here today. And we wish you the very best in your careers as health professionals. Congratulations, class of 2023. Thank you so much, Professor Palmer. Words that we will certainly all remember. This afternoon, the MedSLP faculty is pleased to begin the award presentation, followed soon after by our PT colleagues. Today, I'll be presenting awards for the Clinical Key, the Academic Key, and the Advocacy Award to three members of our graduating class. These awards recognize and honor individuals in the program who have demonstrated exceptional leadership, scholarship achievements, and clinical success. Please join me with our first award for Ms. Avital Weissner, the 2023. For 2 years, and today's the first time we finally see each other in person. It's an honor and a privilege to receive the Advocacy Award today. Advocacy in our field is to connect with our clients on a personal level, to take our work one step further, and seek to understand our clients' unique needs. As speech pathologists, we take pride in our responsibility to provide first-rate support and care to improve our clients' quality of life. It's our mission to advocate for our patients, to ensure that our clients' best interests are given the consideration they deserve. I want to take this opportunity to thank God for giving me the strength to pursue this dream. I truly feel blessed to be standing here right now. I would like to thank my family, specifically my parents, my husband, my grandma. Thank you for supporting me through every step of my SLP journey, for always believing me and pushing me to succeed. I would like to thank my professors and supervisors for molding me into the professional speech-language pathologist that I have become. Our professors have demonstrated how to strive for excellence, to collaborate with other professions, and to advocate for ourselves and our patients. We have worked hard to achieve this degree, but with tremendous motivation and dedication to learning this profession, we did it. Those tireless nights are about to pay off. I know each of you are as excited and committed as I am to see the rewarding impact of our work in the real world. Congratulations, Cohort 6, you did it. Thank you, Avital. Please join me in congratulating Ms. Molly Hampton, 2022 recipient of the Clinical Key of Excellence. Dr. Barrera, and a big thank you to all of our professors who have worked tirelessly to not only teach us the clinical knowledge behind being an SLP, but the human-to-human interactions that make this career so special. I'm very honored to receive this award, but my greatest honor over the past 2 years has been the privilege getting to know so many of you. We have all grown exponentially together as a cohort. After having the chance to work with so many of you at various externships or collaborating on projects together, I cannot wait to see what each of our own strengths, our own personal styles of therapy, and our own personalities can bring to the SLP community. Here's to the 2023 class of YU SLPs. Our final award, and it's a biggie. Please join me in congratulating Ms. Elena Rosenzweig, the 2023 recipient of the Academic Key of Excellence. Elena, please join me.
so much for this award. And a special thank you to my advisor, Dr. who was always making time to meet with me to calm my nerves about clinical placements and give me heartfelt words of wisdom and guidance when I was deciding what direction to take my career. I wholeheartedly believe in the saying, it takes a village. I most certainly would not be standing here today, sorry, if it weren't for mine. Thank you to my family, my grandparents, who are both here today, who immigrated to this country from Ukraine in hopes of a better life for all of us. My parents, my sister, and those closest to me for providing me unconditional support throughout my entire academic career, and for always believing in me when I didn't believe in myself. Thank you to my amazing classmates who are sitting in front of me today. I feel so lucky to have been a part of a cohort that always went the extra mile for one another. I will never forget those of you who took time out of your busy lives to talk through difficult concepts or assignments, and those who offered words of encouragement before exams and presentations. And I especially would like to thank those of you I had the pleasure of meeting in person and working alongside this past semester. You're seriously bonded forever. I can't wait to hear about the amazing things all of you do in your careers. School was never something that came easy to me. As far back as I can remember, I struggled to keep up with my classmates and to understand course material. Back in middle school, my mom began to notice that something wasn't quite right and that I wasn't performing to my fullest potential. I wasn't doing well in school, but I wasn't doing bad enough for my teachers to want to do something about it. Story I feel like we hear very commonly in schools. So my mom fought for me. She advocated for me when I couldn't do so for myself, and she made sure that I got the support I needed, both in and outside of school, in order to be able to have equal access to the curriculum. Maybe through middle school, high school, I got accepted into college, where I discovered this incredible field. And now I'm here. At the end of my graduate school journey, accepting an award for my academic performance, a very full circle moment, something Litalina would have never even imagined was in the realm of possibility for her. But none of it would have been possible if it wasn't for my mom. So I would like to dedicate this award to her, because she was really the key to my academic excellence. Without my mom, who knows where my academic journey would have taken me, and I'm very, very appreciative and grateful to have reached this point, and I look forward to a lifelong career of helping others reach goals that they never imagined reaching to. Thank you, and congratulations again to my classmates. We did it.
All right, our OTD students have many scholars sitting amongst us. So right now I'm going to introduce Dr. Garfinkel, who's going to present the OTD awards. Dr. Garfinkel.
This afternoon, the OTD faculty is pleased to present awards to the 2023 graduating class of OT Scholar Practitioners. These awards recognize honored individuals in the program who have demonstrated academic excellence, clinical excellence, and excellence in leadership. The Academic Achievement Award is given to occupational therapy students with a GPA over 3.85. Please join me in congratulating the recipients of the 2023 Academic Achievement Awards in Occupational Therapy. Dr. Harley Friedman. Feldman, I'm so sorry.
Hi, thank you so much. Thank you.
Oops, I'm so sorry. Okay. Dr. Miriam Graham. Dr. Avni Patel. I didn't do that before. Absolutely. Okay. And one more, Dr. Dina Motechin. Excellence Award is given to students who go above and beyond during their fieldwork experience. They are the students who embody the values of a scholar practitioner whose clinical supervisors commended their outstanding performance. Please join me in congratulating Dr. Renu Abraham, the 2023 recipient of the Clinical Excellence Award. Leadership Award is given to a student who acts as a change agent to positively influence individuals and/or systems towards achieving excellence. During her fieldwork experience with the New York State Occupational Therapy Association, our state association, this year's recipient collaborated with key stakeholders regarding legislative incentives impacting the field of occupational therapy. Further, she acted as a liaison between the New York State OT Association and the YU student body to assure that our students and faculty were aware of legislative happenings. Please join me in congratulating Dr. Yocheved Zion, the 2023 recipient. The Service Award is given to a student who has demonstrated consistent service to the program, such as organizing and participating in the OT Student Association events, which includes service to the community, volunteering with community organizations, and advocating for the profession. Please join me in congratulating Dr. Juliet Gergova, the 2023 recipient of the Service Award. The Scholar Practitioner Award is given to a student who demonstrates intellectual curiosity at all stages of the capstone experience and project. They are the student who seeks knowledge to problem solve and who completes a scholarly project that is grounded in evidence, meeting the needs of a population, community, and/or the occupational therapy profession. Please join me in congratulating Dr. Noah Friedman, the 2023 recipient of the Scholar Practitioner. Join me in welcoming Dr. Barrera.
Congratulations, so many achievements. Please allow me to introduce Professor Andrew Kreisler, who's our esteemed faculty member and the Director of Clinical Education here at the Katz School. Professor Kreisler.
Okay, I'm not going to read that first. Okay, so yesterday was Mother's Day, and the one thing that I signed on for that I didn't know that I signed on for was creating birth plans for so many people. And so many of you became mothers or were mothers in the middle of the program. If you survived graduate school and motherhood at the same time, please stand up and get a round of applause. Wow, just, you know, that. Now I'll read, okay. Teaching in the clinical setting requires healthcare providers to artfully integrate education into patient care experience. It's not an easy feat, and it often goes unrecognized. Today, we honor clinicians who have skillfully trained, inspired, and created a progressive learning environment, demonstrating leadership to the faculty, students, clinical staff, patients, and their families. This year, the award for excellence in supervision goes to Mr. Arnell Brady. He was unable to attend, probably because he lives in Chicago, but the recipient of the 2023 Award of Excellence in Clinical Supervision, Mr. Arnell Brady, we thank you for your extraordinary service, commitment to clinical supervision at the Katz School. Congratulations. And accepting the award on his behalf is Professor Fitzgerald, or we can, sure, she gets to. The recipient of the 2023 Award of Excellence in Clinical Education actually goes to a practice. This practice took lots of students from all over the country, and they unfortunately could not attend because they themselves are physically in California. So we thank the recipient of the 2023 Award for Excellence in Clinical Education is Speech, Language, and Educational Associates, or SLEA, in California for their support of our team. Now for somebody who is here. Okay. The recipient of the 2023 Preceptor of the Year Award is Mr. Felix Tabenschlack. He's here. We'd like to recognize him and welcome him and thank him for his longstanding commitment and partnership between Ahava Medical Center and the Katz School of Science and Health across both our programs, because he took both OT and SLP students the entire time here. So, Felix.
Thank you, Andrew. I just want to say it's such a pleasure and honor to work with the program and to work with the graduate students, I mean speech therapists. Congratulations, guys. Congratulations.
And finally, the recipient of the 2023 Faculty Supervisor of the Year Award goes to Professor Rita Rosenman. Professor Rosenman is recognized for her unwavering commitment and contributions towards student mentorship. Please accept this award on behalf of the graduating class of 2023 for the time, energy, and clinical training experiences you've graciously shared.
Wanted to say a few words. Good afternoon, everyone. I'd like to begin by congratulating all of the graduate students today. This is a major milestone in your lives, and I'm so proud to have been able to work with many of the students here and be a part of your journeys. I'm very grateful to be receiving this recognition today. I'm thankful for you and for all the support and guidance from the whole Yeshiva University team. Being a mentor and a guiding hand is an honor and a privilege. Speech-language pathologists are able to help people in many ways, to help young and old live better lives. Always remember, learning never ends. I'm thankful to have been there in the beginning of your career. Thank you and best wishes for all to have continued success as speech therapists as you go out into the world.
All right. The moment we've all been waiting for. Let's learn about these white coats and pins, because they're equally outstanding achievements. Please allow me to introduce SLP faculty members Dr. Michaela Medved and Dr. Julia Gosto. off script. They don't know this. Surprise. First, let me begin.
Oh, I'm going to get all teary-eyed.
What are you doing?
Really?
Yeah.
For us, you don't do this?
Yes. Please join me in congratulating Dr. Julie Agosto, who earlier this academic year completed her doctorate in education. In healthcare leadership from Nebraska Methodist University and is currently pursuing her second doctoral degree in public health. Congratulations.
Really, before I speak?
All right, I'm going to hold it together for this next one. Okay. Additionally, tomorrow, founding faculty member Dr. Michaela Medved will have the honor of delivering the commencement address at Yeshiva's very own Wurzweiler School of Social Work after completing her PhD in social welfare. Dr. Medved joins a very elite group of faculty who now holds not one, but two doctoral degrees, previously earning her doctorate of science at Rocky Mountain University of Health Professions. Please, please, let's acknowledge Dr. Michaela Medved.
You all may be asking yourself, what is a white coat? In healthcare, a white coat symbolizes professionalism, caring, trust, and authority. A white coat is conferred on graduating students as it marks the transition of study of preclinical skills to clinical health sciences. Today, each Katz MedSLP student will receive their first white coat, symbolizing their commitment to the delivery of clinical services across the lifespan and marking the start of their professional journey.
Without further hesitation, it is with great pride that we commence the presentation of SLP white coats to the graduate clinicians of the class of 2023. Dr. Malowski, yep. Woo-hoo. Dr. Malowski, Professor Mandel, Dr. Sylvia, and Professor Palmer will assume the honor of the calling of the names. Graduates, please proceed to the stage.
By congratulating Jacqueline Asher, who is not here today because she had a baby on Saturday. Serena Babieva. Alexa Bliss. Diane Cabrera. Daniela Capello. Yeah. Kalaw. Daniel Ojeno. Rebecca Flame Crash. Nicole Freeman. Nadia Jellizo. Ita Goldenberg. It is now my privilege to introduce Professor Dylan Mandel.
Molly Hampton. Betsaida Hernandez. Andrew Huston. Samia Jabbar. Agnes Camara.
Sophia Klass. Michelle Kraftstoff. Hannah Lipovsky. It is now my pleasure to introduce my esteemed colleague, Dr. Laura Silvia.
Oh, okay. Krista Moreau. Courtney Murray. Joanna Pace. Pamela Pinos Engamarca. Hannah Polakov. Brielle Prince. Kamiya Rabaran. Ariel Reed. Jillian Rossi.
Atara Rothwax. Elena Rosenzweig. Mitchell Sable. Kushali Singh. Zoe Tavares. Caitlin Velez Brown. Avital Weitzner. Rebecca Merzlikoff. And last, but certainly not least, Miriam Zachary. Congratulations on receiving your white coat, class of 2023, SLPs to be. Let's please welcome Dr. Mindy Garfinkel, who will now begin the process of coding and pinning our OTD students.
Hi again, so you know what's going to happen next, hmm? Okay, so OT graduate programs typically celebrate this transition from the classroom to clinical practice in one of two ways. The first is a white coat ceremony. As my colleagues in speech so beautifully explained, the white coat ceremony symbolizes professionalism, care, and commitment to the client, as well as the transition from the classroom to the clinic, to clinical practice. A pinning ceremony is the second way that graduate OT programs celebrate this transition. During a pinning ceremony, students are given a pin which notes your name and also your new designation as an OTD, a doctor of occupational therapy. The pin will be worn in clinical practice to acknowledge this achievement. We will be melding these two traditions by first presenting you with the white coat and then also presenting you with a pin that you can use for clinical practice. Okay? So I'd like to call up, okay. I'd like to call to the stage, please, Dr. Amia Waldman-Levy, who will be doing the pinning, and Professor Melanie Evangelista, who will be doing the white coat. Ready, ladies? Okay. So the first student I'd like to call up is Juliet Gargova. Okay. McGuire. Harley Feldman. Ariel Niente. Sheila Vesugian. Miriam Graham. Okay. Yocheved Zion. Renu Abraham. Rachel Buckley. Judy Chalou Benjamin. Noah Friedman. Adam Gordon. Dina Motechin. Avni Patel. Ebony Sneed Knight. Thank you. of these beautiful faces and handsome faces with these white coats. How wonderful, entering the field, healthcare, beautiful. Beautiful, congratulations, everyone. Before our closing remarks, as I mentioned earlier, Dr. Alexandra Wagner could not be here today. However, she did write something she was preparing to present. So Dr. Zesire Bodhi is going to read now what Dr. Wagner would like to share with everyone. And we also want to say a special thank you to Dr. Bodhi, who has been one of our founding occupational therapy faculty members in our department. And we will be missing her.
So as mentioned, my name is Dr. Zesire Bodhi, and I am just providing our cohorts with some remarks from Dr. Wagner. She could not be here today. So good afternoon. Her name is Dr. Alexandra Wagner, and she is a clinical assistant professor and the capstone coordinator in the occupational therapy doctorate program. So these are her words. I have had the honor to be a part of your educational journey from the very beginning. I was able to see you master difficult content, develop professionally in activities beyond the classroom, navigate clinical situations, and bring all your skills together in the capstone experience to become scholar practitioners. I hope you all take today to reflect on your accomplishments across the past 8 semesters that you have been with us. Set new goals for yourself so you can use the skills you mastered in the program to propel you forward to your next adventure. I hope you continue to be lifelong learners and maintain a sense of curiosity to meet the needs of society and further advance our profession. I know you will continue to make us proud now that you are transitioning from your role as our students to our colleagues. I wish you nothing but success. Congratulations.
Thank you, Dr. Bodhi. What a gorgeous looking crowd. I am so immensely proud to have this opportunity to provide our closing remarks. So I begin by saying congratulations, scholar clinicians. I congratulate you today for not only earning your graduate degrees, but for entering fields that have once again been identified as one of the top 10 health science careers in America. Bravo. I warmly welcome you to our new community, a fellowship of like-minded individuals who share a common set of beliefs, interests, and patient-centered goals. As clinicians, we are part of a larger community of healthcare professionals, and with that fellowship comes the responsibility to endure that you are always providing the very best clinical care to each and every one of your patients. I know each of you will bring immense pride to the Katz School of Science and Health, and you will be remarkable leaders for our future cohorts. Supervise a student. Just putting that out there now. Supervise a student. 2 years from now, we'll be calling you. One for OT. And we really do mean that. We want you all to come full circle in this journey with us. So today, I remind you that by wearing this white coat and a pin, you are promising yourself and your profession, your patients, and to all of those in humanity that you will have integrity in everything that you do. So in closing, I remind you all to please work hard and stay humble, and remember that true leaders do not create followers, they create more Katz leaders. So families, friends, loved ones, graduates, distinguished guests, this concludes our 2023 Katz School Health Science Celebration. So on behalf of the faculty, staff, administration, we really thank you for joining us for this joyous and fun celebration. So congratulations, graduates.
Guests, we ask that you remain seated while we take photos to memorialize today's events. Students immediately following our procession will be going out to the green to partake in beautiful class photos so we all can remember this milestone. So without any further ado, cue the music!